Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about what a semi-batch reactor is. In particular, we'll talk about how they work, what they're commonly used for, and develop an equation for them. Semi-batch reactors are very similar in theory to batch reactors, which we covered in the previous video. There's a link in the description below if you missed that one. They're just a tank, often with a stirring apparatus in the middle, to ensure that the liquid inside the tank stays well mixed. So, as we learned previously, in a batch reactor, we put in some initial components, such as some reactants or catalysts, then we can let the reactor run for some amount of time. And after that time, we remove our reacted products. So, in this system, there is no addition or removal of material inside the reactor at any point during its run. This is where a semi-batch reactor differs from a batch reactor. In a semi-batch reactor, we are performing some batch, like we did in a batch reactor, but we are now allowed to add or remove something during the process. Therefore, we usually have another inlet or outlet stream to facilitate this addition or removal of mass. But you may ask yourself, why would we want to do this? Why couldn't we just add all our components at the beginning like we did for a batch reactor? That made it so easy. Well, although these types of reactors are not as common as some of the other types of reactors we will see throughout this course, they are great if, for example, we have an unwanted byproduct of our reaction, and we can siphon off that component as a reaction proceeds. Another example of where semi-batch reactors excel is if we have a highly exothermic reaction occurring. So, instead of adding in all of our reactants at time zero, we can start with a small amount at time zero, and then control the inflow of the reactants to ensure that there's always sufficient amount of cooling occurring before adding in more reactant. This prevents a runaway reaction, and it also decreases our cooling costs as the reactor won't get as hot. Semi-batch reactors have similar cons to a batch reactor. That being that they are usually labor-intensive, meaning we need employees to alter the system during each batch, such as cleaning. And as a pro, they really excel at smaller scales. As you can imagine, it would be challenging to scale up a little semi-batch reactor to an industrial scale, as we would need to introduce new potential problems for ourselves. For example, if we scaled our batch reactor to one giant reactor, and let's say we were working with a sensitive product in our reactor, what do you think would happen if we had some contamination of that sensitive product? Well, the whole batch is now a waste, and we just lost lots of time and money, which is obviously not great. Just like batch reactors, semi-batch reactors have their place in industry, but you certainly won't see them in every industry for the aforementioned reasons. Now that we have an idea of the pros and cons of semi-batch reactors, let's talk about an equation to talk about the production of a desired component within a semi-batch reactor. We'll begin with the general mole balance that was developed in a previous video. Link below if you're interested. Now, all we need to do is eliminate terms that are not applicable to the semi-batch reactor. Well, unlike a batch reactor, we can now have either an input of mass or a removal of mass during the process. Therefore, let's split this equation up into the three different scenarios. We could have a scenario where we are only removing mass from our semi-batch reactor. In this case, we have no mass input, therefore this in term is zero. We could also be adding or removing mass from our reactor, and in this case, we cannot eliminate any terms. Lastly, we could have a scenario in which we are adding components to our reactor over time, and we have a zero for the outlet term. Just note, the GA stands for the generation, or consumption, of component A. This term is equal to the rate of formation, in the terms of generation, or rate of consumption, in the terms of consumption, times the volume within the reactor. We will talk more about this in coming videos, though. In conclusion, semi-batch reactors are just batch reactors, except we can now add or remove mass to help us achieve a better product over the simpler batch reactor. In terms of industrial use, these types of reactors are commonly found in the fine chemical, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, food, and other industries, where things like sanitation and temperature-sensitive products are necessary. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your fundamental understanding of what semi-batch reactors are and how they operate. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.